I'm ready.
What's...
Trinity has descended upon us.
Yes. It's hard to describe the feeling.
Come, Hilda. This magic allows your weapon to damage humanity's apparitions.
That's great, but why didn't you do this earlier? Every time I've encountered him, I've wanted to beat the tar out of him.
Both the materials and the effect can only last a limited time. Marble didn't want to share his secret, so I had to figure out a way myself. Confronting Yumen is inevitable. I just hope we don't have to fight the Northwind Legion.
We won't. At least I don't think we will.
I can't promise what will happen on the mountain, but I'll do my best to support you. Is there anything else you want to ask before we go?
I've just got something else.
Time is... Hilda? Are you ready?
I'm ready. On your orders, mistress.
Good. Your morale seems high. I'll meet you at the back of Euphemia Plaza.
Is this magic barrier a defense set up by Marble?
Without it, we won't be able to stop the elite soldiers that are under Humanity's control. But we have to break through it in order to get up the mountain. So, let's get started. Wait, someone's coming. Phew.
Archon Serene!
Mistress Minerva, and your noble warriors too, I see. Today is the Trinity Night. I know you'll be making your move. I don't suppose I could follow you and observe, could I?
We could use all the help we can get, but... you won't go soft-hearted at the last minute, will you?
I was going to ask you the same thing.
Watch your tongue. Stand back. I'm going to break it. More formidable than I thought it would be.
The people of the plaza will be shocked.
Hilda, please clear a path for us. We'll follow close behind.
Leave it to me! I'm coming, Father.
Minerva, I think you already know this, but there's something I'd like to confirm. There is a chance that Eumenides could break away from the Nexus and return to normal.
Iranius told me.
He did? Well, then I'm certain you've already thought the issue over. Did you want to save him, or...?
Please, don't make me regret letting you come along so soon. Let's just say, I'll have my answer once I see him.
Marvel, excited, Sane. What is wrong with them? Why can't they understand my vision? Damn it! I can't let them damage the Nexus. I have to buy some time. Is this Alice? Are you coming out of the Nexus again? Whether for the peace of the Caleb Summit, or for my safety, I'm very grateful. I want to make the world a fair, peaceful, and harmonious place. I need your power to do it. Will you help me, Alice? It seems your replicates are more than enough to deal with them. Go! Stop the Templars! This is good enough. I have an idea that's better than killing them.
been a long time since we had tea together, Father.
Yes, we've both been too busy, even to sit down and enjoy a little quality time together. Which is why we should be completely open with one another. It's just you and me here in the garden. You can let everything out.
Yes, I saw the roses on the table. We both know what that means. Father, just tell me what you want to say.
I know that you and Eumenides are very close, so I must warn you about something. Stay away from his resonator.
How? I helped craft it.
Let him take the credit. You don't need it anyway. You only need to announce that you no longer support it. Let people guess the reason why.
No, I can't do it.
Don't worry. The act will succeed, but...
You plan on hurting Eumenides' secret, don't you? That's why you don't want me involved.
Why would you say that? You really think I'm capable of such a thing? Or did someone make you think that I would? I'm not a murderer, and I know what you and Eumen discussed in private. I didn't hurt his father, and I won't hurt him. He's made many enemies on his own. I don't need to do anything. It's you I'm worried about.
You are just worried about your reputation. If you dare hurt Eumen, I'll do something terrible, Father. All the connections, fame, and fortune that I brought you, I can take it all.
Then I can only wish you all the best, especially when the slaves and the poor start using starlight. You'll understand. As for now, have another cup of tea, my dear daughter.
Very well.
Thank you.
Shay? Garrison?
Hey, why if it isn't the lovely Hilda. What's that look on your face? We're friends, aren't we?
What are you two doing here? Did humanities control you?
What are you talking about?
We heard a loud noise and came over to investigate. You know full well that a broke...
Exactly.
Yep.
Normal as ever.
I don't have time...
Go on.
What is it, child? Palace, if possible. I'd like to be able to study it for a while longer.
Thank you.
So, is it your wits, or the fates that lead you here? No matter, you're an outsider. Come, listen to this ancient tale. A long time ago, there used to be a giant snake living under the tree of stars. It was the great creation of the One, and it oversaw the sinners that were buried under the tree. Should the snake find that a sinner did not atone with full heart, it would devour them whole. The loyalty of the snake dwindled over time, and it began to long for the shining stars on the tree. At first, the snake... The loyalty of the snake dwindled over time, and it began to long for the shining stars on the tree. At first, the snake only circled under the tree, hissing and waiting for any fallen star. But the long wait outlasted the snake's patience, and it crawled up to the top of the tree. Its gigantic body crushed the branches, and it gulped down one star after another, until nearly all the stars were gone. Thank you.